Right,
you know.
One met him and he met me.
Yeah,
and then he met
him.
We met him. Right, then we both bumped into him.
Got that?
Yeah.
Right.
That's how we met.
It was coincidence.
And then we all met him together.
Young people just feel, they can't get into it.
So what do you think young people are going to do in years to come?
Get old.
Under what circumstances does a group sell out? What does that mean to you?
Well, when it comes to bonds, right? Right? And we announce we're going to play some dates, right? Then a lot of people queue up in the morning, right? And buy their tickets, right? And there is no further tickets available, right? That constitutes a sellout.
How do you make certain that you'll keep this attitude? Because I've had a lot of people come through here in the last 8 years that say much the same as you're saying, and then the minute
they've
been
here for 8 years?
Yeah, it's hard to believe the way I do it, isn't it?
Across the wide Missouri.
Like, really, we're goofing and cracking jokes the whole of the way through.
Just to get it across and stop it being boring, because if we just dealt about one particular... help me out
particular.
There, John. Thank you. Particular thing.
Can't you nick my fucking phone? Bag again?
How would you describe what it is you're saying? What the lyrics of your songs that you write are all about?
Now we've had it.
Cult again.
You know. Hello. Well, that's a tough one. What are you saying? I'm shocked and stunned at that.
I can try a definition. I can attempt a definition.
Go on then.
Right. Go on then.
Dandelion.
Joe. Same goes there.
You know, I feel like you've become like the number one punk band in England since the Pistols have called it. Like you've got that focal point.
Yeah, maybe. Possibly. But I always thought.
What do you mean, possibly?
I always thought we were number one.
You thought you were the best all the time,
yeah.
Again?
Yeah, well, yeah, most of the time. Except when I was depressed.
We're all gonna die. You know, and everyone's scared out of their minds, and that's what's brought it out onto the street. The pure, good, honest to God fear.
We haven't mixed it yet. You have to give it a good mix.
Disc jockey Annie Nightingale said she'd give Joe Strummer a Cadillac if the Clash's single didn't get into the top 10. It got to number 11. Now she has to pay up. Fortunately, a listener has come to her rescue and provided the car. Typically, Joe's going to give it away to the steel town of Corby. He reckons they need it more than he does. And anyhow, he can't drive.
Some of us are getting some flats, but they ain't exactly like the castle in Spain that you were talking of, you know. Mm-hmm. It's more like a two-room basement flat.
He's a squatter. You know what a squatter is?
Yeah, that's somebody that comes into a place that does not belong to him and squats there overnight for as long as the
not
authorities...
Not overnight.
Overnight, forever.
Over years.
Right, so they should take notice of the lyrics. But, I mean, let's face it, I mean, you don't go to a concert, you can't hear the lyrics in their shows anyway. Right? You can't hear nothing in their shows.
It was a main bone of contention in the group a lot of the time, apart from food. You know, we used to argue about food. I remember one time we spent an evening fly postering around Camden Town. You know that paste that you make up yourself with flour and water? And we had a bit left over when we finished, and Paul was really starving. So he got this saw, an old saw, and he put the paste on the saw and he heated it up over an electric grill. And you know what? He ate it afterwards. And I didn't do that. I wouldn't do yuck.
Who's all above your hands? Who's all
above your hands? A bit more on the drum box there.
Who's all above your hands?
I think it'll sell.
My mum was there as well at the show, and we were backstage, and I went, "Oh, Mum, this is Andy Warhol."
Right. And then I didn't get the nod after that. I guess that was really uncool.
You've been described, or I think one of you has said, you're a group that's unmanageable. Do you really feel that way about yourselves, that you're maybe unmanageable in the sense of being, forgive me, out of control?
We have a manager.
How's he doing?
We've had him before.
And then he went away for a while and came back, huh?
He went to the funny farm.
Oh.
Where life is beautiful all the time.
Well, it was the eve of a tour, okay? And the tickets weren't selling. And it was practically 3 days before the tour was due to go. So Bernie Rhodes, who with Malcolm McLaren used to lie at the odd scam, he came to me at night and he said, look, you've got to disappear, okay? I said, well, Bernie, if you really think I should disappear, I will. Where do you want me to disappear to? And he said, well, I don't know. Go to Austin, Texas. You know that fellow there, Joe Ely, the country singer? Go and stay with him. He said, but ring me every morning at 10 a.m. I said, okay, Bernie, I'll be seeing you. And so I took the boat train to Paris instead. So I got to Paris, and I thought it'd be a good joke if I never phoned Bernie at all. So he was going to be thinking he was going to be acting, you know, oh, where's Joe gone? And really, he was going, after a few weeks, where has he gone?